Students, welcome to my channel Agricultural Engineering Online. In this video, we will discuss about the short questions from Pharmacy and Power section from GATE 2010. There are 7 questions from this category, 6 or 7 questions. Let us quickly solve these questions or find out the answers. First question, and there is a one more question. Question number 3, it says while carrying out tillage operations, negative slip is sometimes experienced with front wheel of two wheel drive tractor, front wheels of four wheel drive tractor, front wheels of front wheel assisted tractor, or power tiller pulling a mold wheel plow. So basically, you need to understand what are the different options are given. 4 options are given where actually which wheel could have the negative slip. Negative slip means the wheel will move not rooted, but it will move forward. That will only happen for the braked wheel or taut wheel. In this first case, so as you know, so the taut or braked wheel generally skids or negative slip happens. That is, front wheel of two wheel drive tractor is having a that means there is a taut wheel or braked wheel because power is not given. But front wheels of four wheel drive tractor. Both front and rear wheels are powered, therefore there is not a all are powered wheel. Then front wheels of front wheel assisted tractor also there is powered, that's why there is not there. Then wheels of power tiller pulling a mold wheel plow, power tiller wheels are already a powered wheels, but it might also have negative slip when only it pulls or it is operated with rotary cultivator, rotavator. So in this case it is given mold wheel plow, so the answers will be option number A. Therefore, the answer is a front wheels of two wheel drive tractor. Next, a two wheel drive tractor has a PTO speed of 540 rpm and it produces 35 kilowatt net engine power. Corresponding torque available PTO in Newton meter will be the options are given 435 to 558. So let us see the if you see the from the engine through the gearbox, then there will be PTO at the last. So therefore, the engine power is there. Let it 35 kilowatt in this case. It's given, and the last whatever the 540 rpm, and the here rpm is not given, but the rpm at the PTO is given. Therefore, you can calculate now the efficiency between. If it's a only PTO is operated, then generally 85 to 90% power is generally transport to the PTO. If traction is not there, then means wheel is not moving. Then maximum power we are saying. So that's where taking 80 to 85% to 90% transmission efficiency or PTO percentage. The PTO power will be 0.85 to 0.9 times 35 kilowatt. Therefore, converting torque at 540 rpm, power will be equal to 2 pi mt by 60 into 10 to the power 3, or torque will be equal to 60 into 10 to the power 3 into p by 2 pi m. Therefore, the torque one that is if you take the efficiency 0.85%, then the torque will be 526, and if you take torque transmission efficiency is 90%, the torque will be equal to or T2 will be equal to, so you can say this is T2 will be equal to 557. Therefore, the answer will be 535 to 558, because 526 to 557, the nearest option is 535 to 558. Next question, raising the hitch on the implement frame of a pull type offset disc harrow without gauge wheel helps in increasing the depth of penetration for the rear gang, increasing the depth of penetration for the front gang, decrease the depth of penetration for the front gang, and maintaining the same depth. First of all, you need to understand if it's a offset disc harrow without gauge wheel, the front gang and rear gang wheel, the vertical reaction forces will be there, which will define the depth, penetration of the depth. But if you increase the depth, that means the height of the hitching, then what will happen? The G, the soil reaction force, the center point, will generally shift towards the front gang. Therefore, the penetration of the front gang will be more. So therefore, the answer will be increasing the depth of penetration for the front gang, and rear gang penetration will be less because the front gang will be having more vertical force and it will penetrate more. Therefore, the answer will be increasing the depth of penetration for the front gang. Next, A farmer constructed a 2 cubic meter 40 days HRT or hydrolytic time Dinbandhu model biogas plant. The gas will be solely used for cooking in a stove with a burner efficiency of 45%. If the density of biogas is 0.94 kg per meter cube with a heating value of 21 megajoule per kg, the total effective energy available per day in megajoule will be these options are given. Now you need to understand 2 cubic meter 40 days HRT is the just according to this. This is calculated actually 2 cubic meter, how much the volume should be there. Therefore, this is not having any importance on this case. 2 cubic meter each day the gas will be produced. Therefore, this is the volume, then the volume, and this is the density of the gas. So you can find out the mass of the gas, then there is a calorie value per mass. So you can multiply with this. So these three, if you multiply, and also the efficiency, burner efficiency, then the useful heat will be converted. So therefore, the effective energy available will be equal to E let it be. 2 is the cubic meter. So you can see here. So cubic meter, then this is 0.45 with the efficiency. 0.94 is the kg per meter cube. So then 21 is megajoule per kg. So now if you balance it, so kg is cancelled out, meter cube meter cancelled out, so megajoule will be there. Therefore, the energy will be in megajoule, that is equal to 17.766. So answer will be 17.77. Next question is a 2 into 0.3 meter tractor drawn mold plow while operating at a depth of 0.15 meter has a draft of 2.5 kN at a forward speed of 3 km per hour with a field efficiency of 75%. When the speed of operation is increased by 20%, draft is increased by 10%. Assuming field efficiency, soil pulverization, soil immersion to be same at both speeds, the performance into the plow increased by 0, 9, 20, 30%. It's a very simple. So if you encounter this type of problem, basically you have to see what is increasing, what is decreasing. Only these points are important, others are not important. In the case, first of all, you need to know what is performance index. So first, you know, performance index is generally used to find out which performance of different implements. So it is generally defined as this is the formula for this DAIP/D. So here actually you can say D is the depth of the plow, depth of the plowing, A is the effective field capacity, and then I is the inversion, and P is the pulverization, D is the draft. And also effective field capacity is depends on width into speed into field efficiency. In this case, both are all are given, but that is of no use because they will be constant. Therefore, A we can say K into W is the width of the plow, S is the speed, and field efficiency is given. So you can make it constant. Therefore, the PI will be equal to, you can write down instead of A, if you put these three, so that will be like this. So therefore, in the case of everything is constant, only two things are changing. So in the initial case, 3 was the speed, so 3 was the speed and 2.5 is the draft. And in the final case, after some increasing the speed, it's 20%. So that speed will be 1.2 into 3, and increasing the draft 10%, which is 2.5 into 1.1. So change in performance index will be equal to PI2 minus PI1 by PI1 into 100. So basically, it's keeping constant. So this one will be equal to 3.6 by 1.1, and this one will be 3 divided by 3, because the 2.5 will cancel out, then this will be 9.09. So therefore, the answer of this question, the performance index increase percentage will be 9%. Next question, question number 16. While evaluating a stationary power thresher for threshing wheat having a grain to straw ratio of 45% at moisture content of 14%. The following observations were recorded for the duration of 5 minutes. Quantity of grain collected at main grain outlet 16. Quantity of clean grain collected at bhusa outlet 0.3. Quantity of green, clean grain obtained at a sieve underflow outer flow, that is overflow, that is 0.2 kg, and quantity of unthreshed grain from all outlets 0.5 kg. Percentage of known and spilled grains are this percentage. So basically, if you know the thresher are combined, so in threshing efficiency, whatever the crop is fed here, so with straw and grain, here actually the moisture content and time are not important, because we have to get the percentage. Therefore, don't worry about that. Well, only you have to find out the total grain. First of all, 16 kg clean grain is obtained at the tank clean grain output. Then 0.3 kg is obtained at the bhusa. Then 0.2 kg from the all the sieve outflow, overflow, and in, underflow and overflow. Okay. So and unthreshed grain from all the outlets is getting 0.5 kg. Therefore, the total grain input from here actually with without straw, that is total grain inflow will be 16 plus 0.2 plus all the 4, that is 17 kg. Now getting spilled bean and blow. So blowing means that is after blower. Here actually blower will be there. So blow after the blower. So blower will blow the thresh grain to the bhusa outlet, because bhusa is blown. Therefore, the outlet, the getting from the 0.3 kg at the bhusa, that is the blown grain. And the spilled grain means the grain spilled from the sieves, that is 0.2 kg. Therefore, it's very simple. The blown grain percentage will be 0.3 kg divided by 17 kg to total grain into 100, that is 1.76%. And the spilled grain, that is the grain getting from the sieve outflow into, then there is 0.2 by 17 into 100, this 1.18%. Therefore, the answer for this question will be percentage of blown and spilled grain will be 1.76 and 1.18. Next question, the local apparent time or LAT corresponding to 14 hour 30 minutes Indian standard time at a place of in India is which is the latitude is 19 degree 7 minute north and 72 degree 51 minute east. So in the month of April with a time correction of 0 minute will be the options are given. First of all, the local apparent time or standard local solar time, you can say LST or LAT, same thing. The formula is there like this: AST means apparent solar time or local apparent time. There is LST minus or minus or plus depends on, so or minus plus, it might be there. So plus minus 4 into LST minus longitude. So in this case, latitude is 19 and longitude is this much. So in this case actually it is asking LAT, a local apparent time. So it's same as AST. Then LST is in this case IST or Indian standard time. Minus 4 because it's given the east. If east is given, then it's minus. If west is given, then that will be plus. It's very simple. In this case, it's given the east, therefore minus. West, it will be positive. So into LSTM minus longitude. So in this case, LSTM is equal to, we know, LSTM is actually the standard. It's the local solar time meridian. So LSTM is local solar time meridian. So that is standardized by that is the worldwide, but in India, India is a big region. That's why it is decided by the its own LSTM. So LSTM of India is already known. Actually, in the if it is not a big country, small countries or small areas are divided like this: 15 degree into longitude by 15. So this one is actually rounded up to digit, then multiply 15 degree, then LSTM is calculated. But in this India case, LSTM is 82.5 degree. So putting this 82.5 degree in the LAT, LSTM, and longitude is given 72 degree 51 minute, which can be converted direct degree 72.85 degree. So therefore, putting LSTM and longitudinal, so we can calculate LAT or local apparent time, that is 14 hour 30 minute minus 4 in 4 degree, 4 minute into 82.5 minus 72.85 degree, that is equal to 14 hour 30 minute minus 38.6 minute. So we can get it 13 hour 51 minute 24 second. So this is the answer for the question number 17. Hope you understand. Please like and subscribe to my channel Agriculture Engineering Online.